Good morning. Good morning and welcome to Surfside United Methodist Church, whether you're worshiping here with us in person, whether you are worshiping with us online from home or wherever you may be, whether you've been coming here for as long as you remember or this is your first time to worship with us, we're glad that you're here today. There's several announcements for the good of the order this morning. Remember that we will be celebrating the sacrament of Holy Communion today. Hopefully you got your communion elements as you came in. If you didn't get that, raise your hand, and Cindy right back there will make sure that you have what you need. If you're worshiping with us at home, make sure you have some bread, some juice, and we'll be able to share this sacrament together this morning. Remember that your giving statements are in the red box on the bookshelf in the narthex. If you have not picked yours up yet, today would be a good day to do that. Go ahead and mark your calendars. Wednesday, February 17th is Ash Wednesday, and we will be having an Ash Wednesday service here in the sanctuary. It will be streamed online as well at 7 o'clock in the evening. You're invited to join us for worship that day. This morning, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for the ways in which you continue to care for each other in these days. We're wearing our mask, we're social distancing, we continue to do those things. The scripture tells us, do not grow weary in doing good. And although it's been a while since we've been that, I feel as safe here as I do in my own home, thanks to you. So we remember, hopefully we are in the home stretch of this. I get to call and try to schedule an appointment tomorrow morning since they've opened things up to get my vaccine. So hopefully it won't be much longer. But we continue to do these things as a way of loving our neighbors as we love ourselves. And I want to thank you for your part in doing that. Let us now prepare our hearts for worship.
Welcome. Please stand and join me in the call to worship. Have we not known? Have we not heard? Those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall run and not be weary. Let us pray. Generous God, whose love embraces the sinner and challenges the self-righteous, enable us to hear your voice, trusting not in our own worthiness, but in your great love for all people. Amen.
Now let us join together in singing our opening hymn, Praise to the Lord, the Almighty.
Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. O my soul, praise Him, for He is thy health and salvation. O ye who hear, now to His temple draw near, join me in glad adoration. Praise to the
This morning, we turn to the book of the prophet Isaiah. We read from the 40th chapter, much beloved words, 21st through the 31st verses. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told to you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is He who sits above the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain and spreads them like a tent to live in, who brings princes to naught and makes the rulers of the earth as nothing. Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown, scarcely has their stem taken root in the earth when He blows upon them and they wither, and the tempest carries them off like stubble. To whom then will you compare me? Or who is my equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see. Who created these? He who brings out their host and numbers them, calling them all by name, because he is great in strength, mighty in power, not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. This is the word of God to us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. How many of you here, or even wherever you're watching, are living far away from the place that your heart would call home? Some of you, yeah, a bunch of hands this morning. For some of you, that's a long way, maybe clear across country or from another part of the world. Home is that place that has shaped your identity, the people, the landscape, the climate, the culture. Yeah, we say y'all around here. It's as much a part of you as your DNA. Okay, so how many of you have been away from home for more than 50 years? That's a long time. There are a few hands. Yeah, that's a long time to have been away. But you've settled in this place. Maybe you've raised your family here. You've gotten used to drinking sweet tea and really enjoying walks on the beach a whole lot more than you like shoveling snow. But home is still home. There's no place like it. But imagine today that you get the word that it's time to go back. And it's not just you going back, but your whole family will return with you as well. You see, they're not as keen on the idea as you might be. Your children have vague memories of that place, but this is the place where they grew up. Your son married a woman from here, and her family is not so happy about her leaving, and to tell you the truth, she's not real big on the idea either. Your granddaughter just got accepted into that school that's her dream place. And your grandson just made the high school football team. Oh, those two. They haven't spoken in days. This place is their home for as long as they can remember. Sure, they pull for the Steelers because everybody in the family pulls for the Steelers, but they've never been to Pittsburgh, and quite frankly, they're not anxious about going. The passage from Isaiah was written toward the end of the Babylonian exile. The people of Israel have been away from home, the land given by God to their people, promised to them for generations and generations. And they've been forced to live in a faraway country. For some, life hasn't been that bad. They've kept the faith and the practices as best as they were able to, but they've become somewhat acculturated to this strange place and their different ways. For others, life has been served in labor camps. So the word that comes to them, it's time to go home, is met with some mixed emotions. But home isn't going to be like they remembered it. The land has been devastated. The temple is in ruins. After such a long time away, they would not recognize that place as home. When I moved to Anderson 7 years ago, my mother was elated. She and my father had lived there for several years. In fact, that's where I was born. And she was anxious to go back and see it. But 50 years is a long time to be away. So we picked her up and we got her in the car and rode around town. Oh, she remembered the hospital, but the house that they had lived in was no longer there. She saw the church that they had attended while they lived there, but nothing else around it looked or felt the same. It was not the return home that she had expected. Many of us have had a similar experience. It can leave you a little bit disoriented when these landmarks of your life, as you knew it back then, are gone. But through the voice of Isaiah, God speaks a word of hope and of comfort. Those who wait upon the Lord, we hear those wonderful words as they wash over us, and the words that are spoken that give us confidence that the God who has brought us this far will not abandon us now. While the journey will be difficult, God will give them strength. You see, it's going to be the elders and their memories who lead the way. The youth will get weary. The youth will fall out. But it's those elders with that longing for home who are going to lead the journey, and their memories are going to help shape and rebuild the temple and life the way they knew it. And God's power will sustain them every step of the way. They shall renew. You hear those words. They shall renew. They shall rise. They shall run. They shall walk. They will keep moving forward. This is a word that's meant for us today. This past year has felt something like life in exile. And for many people, it has been literally cut off from family, from friends, from being able to worship in this place in person. Everything familiar, all of those wonderful landmarks of our life are no longer there. And it has left us a little bit disoriented. And when this time of exile, when this time of quarantine is over and it's time to go back, much of the familiar landscape will have changed. Some things may have disappeared completely. The way we work, go to school, worship, eat out will continue to be different than it has been in the past. Some things we may be glad to leave behind, the ways that we had overscheduled our time and the frantic pace and pressure that we put on ourselves. For what? We've discovered it doesn't have to be that way. Other things we will welcome once again. Oh, huggers got a hug. They're coming. I can feel them. Y'all are just, we're just waiting for that time. We're waiting for that opportunity to sit down for a meal together or a cup of coffee with a friend. For our normal rituals of celebrating birthdays and joys. And even observing grief. Gathering around the table. Kneeling at the chancel, shoulder to shoulder to receive the bread and the cup. When that day comes, and it will, we will know that it has been God who has brought us this far and will not desert us now. God will lead us into a future that God is already preparing for us and that at this moment only God can envision. The promise of God's continual creative work with its mysterious yet life-giving power continues to be a word of hope for us. God's tired and weary people. Listen for the words from Isaiah. Thanks be to God. As we enter into this time of offering, you may be preparing to leave your financial resources. As you come from the sanctuary this morning at home, you may be writing a check, getting ready to put it in the mail this week, or preparing to go online to make your financial contribution. But in these moments, I would invite you to listen. Where in your life are you waiting for the Lord? Listen for God's voice speaking words of hope and promise and renewal and strength just for you today. This morning we have the privilege and joy of welcoming into the life and ministry and mission of our congregation, George and Susan Myers. They have been worshiping with us for a while. In fact, you probably heard them sing during Advent. We are grateful that they bring their gifts to us in that way. They are the Steelers fans I was talking about in my sermon. Kansas City fans today, I think. But we are glad to have them here with us today. And since you are coming from a sister United Methodist Church, you have been baptized, profess your faith, and we ask you this one question. As members of this congregation, will you faithfully participate in its ministries by your prayers, your presence, your gifts, your service, and your witness?
I will.
Welcome.
Members of the household of God. Members of the household of God, I commend the Myers to your love and care. Do all in your power to increase their faith, confirm their hope, and perfect them in love.
We give thanks for all that God has already given you, and we welcome you in Christian love. As members together with you in the body of Christ, and in this congregation of the United Methodist Church, we renew our covenant faithfully to participate in the ministries of the church by our prayers, our presence, our gifts, our service, and our witness, that in everything God may be glorified through Jesus Christ. Welcome. You may welcome them with a word of applause. And I will invite you following the service to join me out in the narthex, and folks can welcome you in person as you begin to get to know one another better. Thank you.
The Lord be with you. We lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. Before the mountains were brought forth, you had formed the earth. From everlasting to everlasting, you alone are God. You created light out of darkness and brought forth life on the earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ, in whom you have revealed yourself, our light and salvation. In his baptism and in table fellowship, he took his place with sinners. Your Spirit anointed him to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed,
and to announce that the time had come when you would save your people. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. And now, with the confidence of beloved children of God, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And if you're here in the sanctuary, if you'll now take out your communion cups. If you are at home, now's the time for your bread and juice at home. And if you will peel off the film to get to the wafer. The body of Christ, broken for you. And now the juice. This is the blood of Christ, shed for you. And let us pray together. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit, to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
And now let's rise and all join in our final hymn, Open My Eyes That I May See.
God will lift you up on the eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. As you go forth this day, remember that you do not go alone, but that God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit go with you and remain with you now and forever. Amen.